Morning, dear children. Today we are going to begin our second poem, Dad and the Cat and the Tree. The poem is written by Kit Wright. Now, dear students, please look at the poet name is Kit Wright, is the poet of this poem. Now, please look at the picture, the textbook. Have you ever tried to help an animal in trouble? Read this humorous account of a man who tries to help a cat stuck in a tree. So, the poet asks a question to all of us. He asks a question to you. Have you ever tried to help an animal in trouble? So you are in fifth grade, or the same question you can ask to myself. Have you ever tried to help an animal in trouble? Yes, of course I did. So the question to you now, did you do? Now let's read this poem. Read this humorous account of a man who tries to help a cat stuck in a tree. See, in this first stanza, there are many stanzas are there. So each stanza consists of four lines. In this morning, a cat got stuck in our tree. Dad said, right, just leave it to me. So each stanza consists of four lines. And the second stanza and third stanza, there are two words. Okay, we will be explaining later when we reach the second stanza. Now let's focus on the first stanza of this poem. This morning, a cat got stuck in our tree. Dad said, right, just leave it to me. So what does it mean? The above lines have been taken from Kit Wright's poem, Dad and the Cat and the Tree. The context, the poet showcases how the narrator's father takes the responsibility of dealing with the cat. And the narrator discusses that the morning a cat got stuck in a tree, his father told him that he will manage to drive away the cat. That is in the first stanza. Now, let's move to the second stanza. The tree was wobbly. The tree was tall. Mom said, for goodness sake, don't fall. Now, dear children, let's underline this word. Wobbly. What is mean by wobbly means not steadily. The tree was tall. Mom said, for goodness sake, don't fall. Same as in the first stanza one, the context is the poet describes the narrator's mother's concern for her husband. Okay. Stanza one, same context here. The poet describes the narrator's mother's concern for her husband. The explanation is that since the tree was unstable, the narrator's mother was full of doubts as to how easy would it be for her husband, how easy would it be for her husband to climb the tree, Therefore, she warned him that he might fall. So his wife has warned him that he might fall. He may fall sometimes. Not sure for it. Now let's move to the third stanza of this poem. Fall, scaffold, dad, a climber like me, child's play. That is, you wait and see. Scuffle means here comes, see, scuffle. Scoffed means, not scuffle, it's scoffed. Scoffed means spoke in a mocking manner. Scoffed means spoke in a mocking manner. Now let's see. Just like stanza number one, the contest is almost same. The poet discusses how narrator's father laughed away his wife's warnings. So his wife has already given him a warning. Now let's see the explanation. Listening to his wife's warnings, the narrator's father was quite surprised. He dismissed away these warnings. That means he has got rejected those warnings by saying that he was a good climber. He himself was confident about him that he is a good climber, saying that he was a good climber and was climbing the tree was easy as a child's play. And he himself says that it is quite easy task. What? The climbing a tree was an easy as child's play. It is easy just like child's play. It is easy task to climb a tree. Now, dear students, let's move the fourth stanza. He got out to the ladder from the garden shed. It slipped. He landed in the flower bed. See, what is that contest? The poet highlights how the narrator's mother fears to prove to be true. Okay, what she has said, it is true now. The explanation is that the narrator's father brings out a ladder from the garden shed, but it slipped and father fell on the ground. What happened? Father fell on the ground. Now, stanza number five. Never mind, said dad, brushing the dirt off his hair and his face and his trousers and his shirt. See here what happens. Now, the contest is that the poet describes the father gathering back his energy. He has got back to his energy. How? The explanation is that the narrator's father brushes off the dirt from his hair and clothes. Already he has mud, some dirt is already in the hair. So he cleans his face and begins to think about another plan to drive away the cat. So he has planned, he has started to think another plan. How can I drive away the cat? Now, the sixth stanza, we will try plan B. Stand out of the way, mum said, don't fall again. Okay, again, okay, comes in the next page. The reference is that the poet shows how the mother seems to be dissatisfied with the plan B as well. Okay, the narrator's father decided to try plan B. His wife, however, again warns him. So the wife is again warns him what? That he might fall again. So she was saying that you might fall again. So let's move the next page. Again, okay, again, okay, is part of the previous stanza. Okay, stanza number seven. Fall again, said dad, funny joke. Then he swung himself up on the branch. It broke. So what happens here? The poet showcases how the narrator's father again dismisses his wife's warning. I mean, again, he rejected the wife's warning. Again, he rejects his wife's warning. The explanation is that the narrator's father mused away his wife's warning. Then, still laughing, he swung himself on a branch, but the branch broke and he again fell on the ground. What happens? The branch broken and he fell on the ground. Now, let's move to stanza number 8. Dad learned wallop. Back on the deck, mom said, stop it, you will break your neck. So the another word, let's underline and mark it, wallop. What does it mean by it? It means hit hard, hit hard, hit hard. back to the deck, mom said, stop it, you will break your neck. So next warning. So poet reiterates the narrator's mother's intervention. Again she interfered. The explanation is that the narrator's father again fell on the ground. The narrator's mother begged him, requested him, stop it, to stop, as he might break his neck from falling again and again. Suppose you fall again from the top of the tree, next your neck may break. Please stop it for us, for all, for the time being. Please stop it. So stanza number 9, rubbish, said dad. Now we will try plan C. Easy as winking to be a climber like me. The contest is that the poet highlights how the narrator's father refuses to give up. He was not ready to give up. He was not ready to stop it. The explanation is that narrator's father then decided to try plan C. Plan B was failed. Now plan C. He was still confident that being a great climber, he would succeed. Being a great climber, he would succeed. The plan C, plan B was failed. So plan C, he was much confident than plan B, that being a great climber, he would succeed. He will succeed over it. Now let's move to stanza number 10. Then he climbed up high on the garden wall. Guess what? He didn't fall. He gave a great. He didn't fall. Okay, until then is enough. He didn't fall. What does it mean? The contest. The poet shows the father trying yet another plan. Okay, the father was trying another plan. Explanation is that the narrator's father climbed up the high garden wall. What he has done? He has climbed up the wall. The wall is already there. You can see on the picture itself. In the picture itself, the wall can see in the picture itself. So what did he do? The narrator's father climbed up the wall. Climbed up the wall. Garden wall. Actually, this is the garden wall. Okay. And this time he didn't fall. What happens? This time he didn't fall. So stanza number 11. Let's see the stanza number 11. He gave a great leap and he landed flat in the crook of the tree trunk right on the cat. What does it mean by crook? And let's underline this. Crook. What does it mean? Crook. Crook. Here comes the curved part of a tree where the trunk splits into two or more branches. See the picture? The picture shows that, isn't it? The part of a tree where the trunk split into two. Here comes one, here comes another. Split into two. Okay? That is crooked. Right on the cat. Here comes the contest is that the poet describes that finally the narrator's father succeeds. Finally, what happens? He got succeed. The father with a great leap finally land on the top, right on the cat. Finally, he has reached on the top, just close to the cat. What happened the next? That is something. Let's see what happens next. The cat gave yell and spreading ground, pleased with the punch to be safe shot, so it is smiling and smirking. What does it mean? Let's see, smirking. Now, in the stanza number 11, we had already seen that he has already reached closer to the cat. The poet described the finally narrator has succeeded. The father, with a great leap, finally landed on the top, right on the cat. Now, stanza number 12, the cat gave a yell and sprang to the ground, pleased the punch to be safe on the safe and sound. See, the contest is that the poet humorously ends the poem. He was going to be end the poem. The moment the father landed on the cat screamed with fear. The cat screamed with fear. Screamed means cried with fear. And sprang to the ground. Landing smoothly on the ground, it seemed the content with itself. The cat which jumped on the ground. Now, Let's see stanza number 13, last stanza. Oh, okay, okay, sorry. Here the word smirking means smiling in a way that shows pleasure at someone's misfortune. Now, let's focus the last stanza of this poem. So, it's smiling and smirking. Okay. Smiling and smirking. Among us can be, but poor old dad's still stuck up on the tree. It shows that the contest is that the poet described the father's poor situation. Now, the poet describes the father's poor state. What does it mean? The narrator describes that having safely landed on the ground, the cat was smiling arrogantly while his father got struck on the tree. Finally, what happened? Father has got struck on the tree. Finally, father has got struck on the tree. Hope you understand the poem clearly. I hope you understand the poem very clearly. Then please write down the word meaning which was shown in the yellow color. Write it down and write the meaning. Listen to the word again. Listen to the video again and find out the word meaning. Hope you understand the poem very clearly. Thank you. Thank you for listening to me. Have a nice day.